Well, another hot one out there. We climbed up to 99 degrees today in Bryan. This is 2 degrees above that average, 98 in College Station. Those temperatures have fallen into the mid-90s, though, in BCS, 94 degrees. Take a look at that Western Zone, 101 in Giddings, 100 in Rockdale, as well as Temple. So those hot temperatures continuing to stick around, and it's really expanding across the entire state. 103 in Del Rio, 103 in El Paso, 101 in San Angelo. So those hot temperatures sticking around. There is a little cold front sneaking down into the Texas Panhandle, northern Oklahoma. That's going to remain to the north of the Brazos Valley, triggering some showers and storms there. The main weather feature is going to be this upper level ridge across Texas. That's going to keep those temperatures hot as we head throughout the day tomorrow and over the next several days. We will see a little outflow boundary kind of sneak its way into the southern parts of the Brazos Valley heading into tomorrow afternoon, a little sea breeze boundary, but it's not expected to generate any showers or storms due to this upper level ridge continuing to dominate the weather. Now, the boundary across Oklahoma going to trigger some showers and storms as we head into Wednesday, and that's going to send a little thunderstorm complex in the northeastern parts of Texas. But unfortunately, it looks like that's going to fizzle out before it moves into the Brazos Valley. It will send a little outflow boundary to northern parts of the area as we head into Wednesday afternoon. That paired with a little sea breeze working into the southern zone could generate enough lift to spark one or two storms. But right now, I don't have any rain chances in that forecast. I will continue to monitor that, though, over the next few days. The main weather feature is just going to be this upper level ridge. It's going to be just kind of bouncing around the state over the next few days before it gradually starts to work into the desert southwest. And that's going to keep our temperatures in the upper 90s and triple digits throughout the entire week. You want to make sure you're staying hydrated out there. Protect those pets. And again, make sure you're wearing sunscreen as well with mostly sunny skies. Now, the good news is we're looking at a pattern change heading into next week. It looks like a cold front could sneak into the Brazos Valley, and that would drop those temperatures. The latest outlook from the CPC is showing that we could see temperatures near to below average for a large part of next week, with those precipitation chances going up as well. We will take that after we've been so hot and dry over the past several days. And this is right on cue with climatology. Around mid-month, that's when we see the hottest temperature of the year, that average high of 97 degrees. The average low was 75. Notice, though, it starts to decrease as we head toward the end of the month into September. And then take a look at this. As we head into September and toward the middle of the month and eventually October, those highs come down into the mid-80s and those lows fall into the 60s. Oh, goodness, I will take that. I'm ready for some fall-like weather. We're taking a look at the tropics as well. We do have a little tropical wave that has a 60% chance of development over the next 5 days. So we're going to continue to monitor this. The models are showing this continuing to work toward the west northwest over the next few days and eventually impacting the Windward Islands. Right now, looking like it's going to fizzle out before it hits the U.S., but we will continue to monitor that. The big news on this 10-day forecast, Gabriella and Tristan, is that we have a cold front that's going to work in next week. Now, it's not going to be cold, but we're going to see those temperatures fall into the 90s, the low 90s for highs, and maybe those overnight lows slipping into the 60s. We will take that any day of the week in August.
He always gets our hopes up with like, oh, there's a cold front, but then.
But not that. He did disclaim that there was, it's not going to be that cold. It's going to be cold for Texas.
But a 10 degree temperature drop, that's pretty significant. We will take it. It's going to lower that humidity. The overnight lows are going to be in the 60s. When was the last time that happened here in BCS? Ooh. It's been months, so we will take it.
And I apologize, I did not get my car washed this weekend, so.
Tristan, I blame it on you. This is why we have all the sunny skies out
there.
The hot temperatures
are
all your fault.
Send it my way. Don't
Tristan,
go through Chris.
I want you, over the weekend, I want you to wash your car so this cold front moves through and brings some rain.
I'll do that. I promise.
Apparently these two control the weather. We'll have sports up next. Stay with us.